Okay, so today we're going to be focusing on Google Drive, like I said just a second ago. And our learning intention that's in our success criteria is basically that I'm going to learn how to do the following things in Google Drive: create and organize my files, upload files, search for through Google Drive, etc. We're also going to play with a few settings and different things like that. And I will know that I'm successful in Google Drive when I can use Google Drive to create, access, upload, etc. I'm going to do some basics, and then I'm going to do some that's a little bit more advanced so we can kind of hit both. But if you have any questions at any time, just let me know, and that'd be awesome. Okay, so the first thing that we want to talk about in our Google Drive is our settings. So I'm going to kind of be going off a slideshow, but I'm going to be putting that on my bottom screen, and then I can upload it later so people can see it if they want to. But basically in Google Drive, the first thing that you want to play with is when you're using Google Drive is your settings. And there's one specific thing that I wanted to show you. So up in the top right-hand corner of your Google Drive is this little settings button. And in that settings are going to be this one right here. And that is our convert uploads. A lot of people, when they are using Google Drive, when they upload a document from their computer, they're uploading it, and then it stays in a Word document format, which a lot of times kind of messes things up later on. So I highly suggest if you're creating a document new, just start it in Google Drive, and I will show you how to do that in a second. But if you are pulling it in from your computer, I would highly suggest having this turned on. So it's going to convert uploaded files to that Google Docs editor format, which just makes it a little bit easier and a little bit more convenient. So I believe when you first go into this, it's going to be turned off. You want to just make sure that that is turned on. Okay. The other one I was just playing around with a little bit is this suggestions. Okay. And I like this one that says that relevant files are handy in quick access. I'm going to show you where quick access is in just a second. But these are files that you use often, like your last used file. You can quickly go to that quick access and it will just show up there for you. And the other one that I really liked is that is this one. And I'm not sure if I'm going to turn it on or not, but is this make priority my default homepage? And basically, I'm going to show you where priority is in just a second and show you how that can be an advantage. But I think that this one could be a really good one, especially if you have like 1,000 documents in your Google Drive. You can change your priorities and create groups, etc., that are a little bit easier for you to use. Okay, so those are the settings. There are like notification settings and different things, but those are the ones that I kind of want to focus on right now, is just that convert uploads, because that's the most important, and then these little suggestions. Okay, so now that we've done that and we've talked about the convert uploads, the next thing we're going to do is talk about our search feature, because I'm going to guess that you guys get a ton of Google Drive documents at all times, and you don't always remember what they're called or where you stored them. So one easy thing to do is you could just come here and search for the name or the document that you're looking for. If you're not finding it right off the bat, if you come to this down arrow right here, this is going to allow you to search in different ways. So for example, I may want to search a certain type of file. So maybe I know that that file that I'm looking for is a PDF. I could come right here and search a PDF. And then it's like, who's the owner of it? Well, I'm pretty positive that that document that I'm looking for came from, and I can say a specific person. And so for example, if I said Danae, so I'm looking for a PDF that was created by Danae or shared with me by Danae. She's the owner of it. Okay. I can look anywhere, or I can say that I want to look in specific locations. And then I can do like a date modified. Okay. If I have like keywords or different things, I could put those there. It may help me narrow it down. But if I have no idea what it was called, sometimes it's best if you just click on the search button, and now notice it's searching for a specific person and a specific type of document. So now I can go down and find the one I'm looking for. So maybe it was this one, and then I would be able to double click to open it up. So that search feature can come in super handy. Any questions so far? Okay, sounds good. I will just keep going then. The next one that I kind of wanted to focus on is just over here on this new. Okay, when I click on new, when I click on the new button, it's going to ask me what I want to create. So this is that you are actually doing the building of something. So I can create a folder, or I can bring in a Word document, Google Sheets, slides. If I click on more, there are a ton more options that show up. So for example, maybe I wanted to build like a Google Sites or something for my faculty. Usually you would do this on like Canvas or something, but know that that is a possibility. Jamboard is also a really popular one right now to help build like graphic organizers or to help that collaboration process. I may focus on that one in a later training, but know that that's where you would find it, is under that more section. So when I am bringing something in, I can either bring it in new, which is these documents, or creating a new folder, or I could do a file upload or a folder here. Okay. One thing that you should know is that you can, instead of creating new, you could, for example, if I have a document, like a image or something like that, so here's my image, I could click and I could just drag that in. And when I drag it in over the top, I'm going to get go back to my drive instead of being in the other documents. But I could come and drag this in. Notice that blue bar comes up, and so then it's like, where do you want to drag it? So if I want to, I can just drag it straight into my drive, and I can do that over on the left-hand side, or if I just do it quickly while that blue box is hovering over everything, that's going to show me that it's going to go in the my drive instead of any one of those specific locations. So if I wanted to, I could click and drag it into my drive there, and now it's going to upload into that My Drive. Okay, I will know that it's uploading into my Drive or anywhere, because over here, it's going to show that my upload is complete, and it's also going to show that that image that I just added, or it could be a folder or a document for that matter, is going to show up here. Notice it has a check mark right now saying that it's done it. But if I come to hover over the top of it, I do see that file location. And when I click on that file location, I can easily see where it's at, and it will locate that file for me. So it's currently locating it. So I can do it that way as well. All right, any questions on adding files or documents? All right, so I'm going to go down to the next one then. So in my Google Drive, there are a few different options over on the left-hand side. Priority, My Drive, and Shared Drives. I'm going to start with My Drive, and then I'm going to bounce up to Priority. But My Drive, okay, when I click on it, My Drive is going to pretty much be anything that I've created, or anything that I've brought from like a shared drive and asked it to add into my drive. Okay, so you can organize your drive by creating folders, and that's what we just talked about. So you have you can create your new folder, or I could come here and do a two-finger click on my drive, and I have that same option to create a folder there. When I create a folder, okay, then I am able to add different pieces into it. So for example, if I have this document right, or this folder right here, and I want it to go into my .techcoach2018 folder, I could just click and I can drag it, and notice that blue is going to tell me where it's going to go. So I could easily drag it into that folder. My other option is, if I don't see it easily right here in those top couple lines, I could come over to my left-hand side, hit that down or that arrow, which will now create a down arrow. Maybe. And then all of my folders are going to show up here. So now what I could do is take my dot practice right here, and maybe I want to move it into a folder that is farther down my list. So I'd be able to click on it and now drag it over here to that left-hand side and put it into the folder I want to. Notice that over on the left-hand side, I'm only going to see folders, even if I drill down into them. So here's this one, and I want to drill down into it. It's still only showing me folders. If I want to see the actual documents, I need to click into this folder. And then when I click into the folder, it's going to then show me any documents. But that left-hand view is only going to show me folders, and then I can drag different items into those folders. Any questions so far? Okay. So the next thing I'm going to kind of show you is your different options with your folders. So when I have a folder here, for example, that practice PD folder, I can click on it once, which is going to highlight it for me, but I can click on like a two-finger click, and it's going to give me options here. One option that I really like is the color change. So for example, if you have a folder that you're using often, you could change the color of it, or if you have like maybe multiple different things you're working with. So for example, if you are working with different groups of people, maybe like a kindergarten or first grade or second grade, you could change it and have like your green be your kindergarten group and your red be first grade. So anytime you see a folder with that color, you know it's going to relate back to that grade level, etc., or that group of people. So maybe you're working with parents on something and students on something and other coaches on something, whatever it is, you can come here, change that color to match what you want it to be. Okay, so that is an option. Notice other options right here. This is where you could share your file or your folder, I guess. It works the same way for files though. So when I come here to share, I can come and do my get link. Okay, I can share here. And when I'm sharing here, this is meaning that it's going to show up in their shared with me file. Okay. And I'll show you where that is in just a second. So if I decided I wanted to share that shared with Danae, I could either type in her name, or because I use her often, it's going to show up there. And now I can say what rights I want to give her. If I want to give her view rights, commenter rights, or editor rights. From here, I can send her a message, and that's going to show up in her Google email, okay? So her CSD Docs email, and then I would be able to send it that way. Another option, if you don't want to actually share it with them and that's going to put it into their drive, you just want them to be able to see it, is giving them the link to it. So when I do this copy link, there's actually more options than just this. I can change it to different options. So now I can say anyone in Canyon School District, the staff, has these different options. So I can say instead, I want to share it with Canyon School District, which means that it could be staff or students. Or maybe I just want to share it with anyone with the link. That's going to take it outside of Canyon's district. So maybe I need something that parents might be seeing. Okay, I could change it to anyone with the link, and it's going to give them the option. Know that students don't have the option to, to share it with anyone with the link. They only can share it inside of Canyon's district. So once I've done that, I can say if I want whoever I'm sharing it with to be a viewer, a commenter, so viewer means that they can see it and do nothing else with it. Commenter means that they can see it and make comments on it. And the editor means that they can add the files, edit files, organize them, and pretty much have any of the same rights that you as the owner of that file have. So that is sharing. I'm going to do another two finger click and just make sure that there's nothing else. Okay. The only other thing, so obviously I think these kind of all make sense. The only other one is this download. This is if you want to download it to your computer. Usually what happens if it's a folder, it's going to download it as a zip. And then what you do is have to double click on that folder that downloads, and it will create another folder that has all of your documents in it. So there's your download. And it, if you're doing like a bunch of stuff at the same time, it's best to create one folder and put all of the other folders in it and then download that one folder, and it will download everything at once instead of trying to download like 25 different little folders. All right, what questions do we have so far? None? Okay.
You're being really clear. Thanks, Chandra.
Yeah, of course. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna go over to our left-hand side over here. And right now we have our My Drive that we just kind of talked about. The next one I wanna talk about is this priority. So priority is going to be a great reference for you. Basically, a lot of times principals or teachers or different people will create files and they'll put them in their own folders. And for you, they all relate, but for them, they want to they don't relate, or they need to keep them separate. But for you, you may need to create a space where all of those files go into it. So that's where this workspaces is going to come in for you. And what you can do with workspaces is you can create a folder, or not a folder, but a workspace. So I can click right here and click on create. And then I can do change it. So maybe I need to do a new coaches folder that I'm able to throw all kinds of documents in that are going to help. So I can come here and click on create. And now it's going to open it up for me. So now I can say, what files do I want to use for my new coaches? So notice it automatically says, hey, do you want to add these files? These kind of have something to do with that idea. And so I could say, yeah, I do actually want to add those files. And now I can add those selected files. So now when I click on the done, those files are already in there. But I can also come back to view that workspace and add more files. And it's just an easy way to bring files that are in all kinds of different folders together into one space where you know where they're at. So this is one of my new favorite tools that I've been starting to play with. Not super amazing with it yet, but I think the more that I go, the better it's gonna get. So as you can see, it's like, here's my Quell Hollow folder. As I start getting more information about Quell Hollow, I may start adding more documents to that, and same with my Willow Springs. Priority is what we talked about before when we were talking about settings. And these are documents that you use often. And so it's gonna throw them into priority. And then you can just use your arrows over here to be able to get to them really easily instead of having to search for them. So that could kind of be a big benefit as well. Going back to your My Drive really quickly, one other thing that I forgot to show you, okay, in your My Drive, and this will show up, I think, in your shared drives as well. But right here under your My Drive, you can decide how you want your documents to be viewed. So if you want them, you could do it by name, and you could bring that up or down so it's in alphabetical order. You could also do it by date last modified. So I could say, do I want it by last modified by me, or the date that was last opened? So last modified by me will probably bring it more and change it to more of like that priority view of what am I been using recently. And so you can access them really easily. And then file size and owner doesn't really matter. Well, it does, because you can see who is the owner of it and what the file size is. But know that in Google Drive for education, which is what we're using, it doesn't really affect anything because our Google Drive is pretty much unlimited. So notice I currently have 92 gigabyte in here. You can have as much as you need to for education. Okay, any questions yet? Okay, the next thing that I wanted to show you was in your settings that I forgot to show you, and that is going to be when I come right here to my settings, and I do my two-finger click on it. Okay, one thing that I forgot to show you is this star button, add to starred. And when I add to starred, that's going to bring it over here into my starred documents. So anything that I use often, I could also put in there. I kind of have a lot in here right now, and I kind of need to clean that out. But I would highly suggest only keeping maybe 10 items in that starred, because what that's going to do is it's going to give you a really quick reference place of where to find your very important documents really, really fast. Okay, so the next one that you want to look at, or we want to look at, is Shared Drive. And Shared Drive is an excellent resource. Because basically what it does is it allows you to create folders, okay, or what they call shared drives that allow more than one person to technically be an owner of it. So what that kind of means is if I am building a folder, let's say, for example, for Willow Springs Elementary, and I build that folder, and then I get a job outside of the district, when I leave, all of those resources are going to disappear with me. But if I have them in a shared drive, basically what's going to happen is it's just going to transfer ownership to another person. So none of those documents or anything are going to disappear. They're just going to be transferred. So when I come here, I can see that I have my different members. Okay, so this one has 202 members to it. But I can also come in here and view those members. And then I can see who's got what abilities. So notice that most people are viewers, but let's say that you needed to add something to this and you're a viewer. You could come down here and you could see like Ashley Lennox right here is a content manager. So you could ask her for help adding something because she can add something. Or you could ask the manager. So I don't know who the manager is of this, but the actual manager, not a content manager, if they will give you maybe like contributor rights or content manager rights that will allow you to add or detract from this. Because right now, what most of these people have is that view right. So they can see stuff in there, but they can't add or detract from it. So just kind of know that that's where you would find it. So if you're not able to add anything that you need to, you can talk to one of those people. To either give you rights or to do it for you. All right. Do you have any questions with shared drives? Okay. So the next one I wanted to look at is shared with me. Shared with me can become really, really messy, really, really fast. Okay. Basically, anytime someone adds you to something or shares a document with you, it's going to show up in here. So if you're added to a certain folder, or if you're added to whatever, okay, or even like you have students or parents or something sharing documents with you, they're going to show up here. So you probably are going to have hundreds, maybe thousands, maybe hundreds of thousands of documents in here, okay? I usually ignore my shared with me. It's really not that important. But when you're working with someone and they share something with you, so for example, these agenda notes that Lauren shared with me, I could go in and say, okay, these are great. I actually do need these. And then I could do a two-finger click on them and say, add shortcut to drive. So then it's going to pull it into my My Drive where I can organize it and put it where I actually want it instead of it being like a big cluster mess right here in that shared with me drive. So you're not going to be able to like take ownership of it or anything like that, but you are able to add a shortcut. So you're able to see it inside of your My Drive. Okay. Any questions with your shared with me?
Okay. All right. Thank you so much for calling.
Okay.
Oh, you're so then, doing great. Sorry.
No, you're good. I noticed that you froze for just a second, so just check in. Okay. I did want to show you a little tip and trick that I learned about last spring that I thought could be helpful. So what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to connect my phone and present from my phone for just a second, because I think that this could be a benefit. Let me see if I can stop presenting for just a second. I'm going to get on a Google Meet on my phone. And I'm going to join a meeting. Of course, I spelled it wrong. I'm going to click and join this meeting.
And I'm going to turn a sound off on the computer. Okay, that should have worked. Did that work? Okay, so from here, I'm going to show you how we can actually take a document, like a, for example, like a PDF or something, and we are going to be able to change that to a workable document on Google Docs. So from here on my phone, I'm just going to share my screen with my phone really quickly. Let's see if that works. Perfect. So from my phone, I'm going to go to my Google Drive. And inside my Google Drive, I have that plus sign on the bottom right-hand side of my screen. And when I click on that plus sign, on a document that is something like, on a phone that is not an iPhone, you're actually going to have a scan button where that use camera is. But iPhones don't have it, but it's okay. So what we're going to do is use the camera. So I clicked on that use camera button, and now I'm able to come over and take a picture. So I'm going to take a picture of this vaccine option. So from here, I can click on the bottom right-hand side where it says use photo. So now I've used that photo and notice it's processing and it's pending my upload. So now I've taken a picture. This is kind of like taking like a scan of that image. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop presenting on my phone and head back to my computer. So from here, I'm back on my computer. Can you see my screen on my computer? Okay. So from here, I can go back to my My Drive. And now I have this document that I just uploaded. I can do a two-finger click on it. And instead of just opening it like normal, where it's going to be an image, I can actually come and open with and open it with Google Docs.
Can you hear me?
I think I heard that you can open it with Google Docs, and then I didn't hear anything for a minute.
Okay, so I'm back. Okay, so basically what I did is I did my two-finger click, and I said open with Google Docs, and now it opened it up as a document. Here's my image that I used, and now it actually converted all of the text on that image to its own Google Doc. So I know like a lot of times teachers or whatever are trying to, they'll have like a what is it called? Like a PDF or something of something that they're working on in class. And they want that to transfer to something that they could use with their students, maybe through Canvas and Google Docs or something like that. This is a great way to do it because it still has the image on there. And once it's in there, it usually comes in Cricut, but I can rotate that image. So there's the actual image. There's my assignment. And now I have my option with the actual document where it has typed everything in for me. It's not quite perfect all the time. So for example, this is DIDO or whatever, you know, so it's not exactly perfect, but it's really nice that I don't have to type everything back in and I can just go in and make those corrections that I need to. So
that's amazing.
Yeah, it's super nice. And then what you can do, if you're doing it with like students or whatever, you would be able to come in here and have, you know, if you have like, here's your question, then you could type in like something like response and then have them type in that response, you know, and you can have that in red or something. So you can easily see that. So those are the basics of Google Drive. And then I kind of added that last piece on as a little bit of extra. But what questions do you have? Or what further support do you need with Google Drive?
I learned some things today. Thanks, Chandra. I think as far as Google Drive goes, I feel pretty comfortable with it. I really like the extra pieces like color coding files. I hadn't done that before, so that's going to be helpful. And I appreciate you going through the share settings. That was something that I wasn't sure exactly how it worked when people got them. So that was helpful for me. I can't think of anything else. Like I really wanted to hear about the share settings the most. And you covered that. So I think I'm good to go.
Perfect. One other thing. So you said you like the color coding. So one other thing that you probably saw that I did is the period at the front. So if there's a document that you're using or a folder that you're using all the time, if you put like a period at the beginning of it and you put them in alphabetical order, that's also going to bring it all the way up to the top. And that helps so much when you need to use things often. So,
oh, that's good. Note. I've cheated with a zero.
There you go. Perfect. That's definitely another way that you can do that. So. Any other questions? If not, I will, you know, let you go.
No, I think I'm good. Happy holidays and thanks for your time. I appreciate it. You put in prep to get this done and I appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks for coming. Have a great break.
Thanks, you too. Bye.
Bye.